welcome back. We're welcoming our first guest, Ms. Noxzema Nash, Without the Rash. Come on, Noxzema. Noxzema, thank you so much for being on my show today. You're looking fabulous, darling.
Thank
Have
you.
A sit. Ooh,
thank
you even
you.
Got some hips. Oh, girl. Honey, I understand.
Oh.
But anyway, darling, so, you know, Noxzema, I've been reading the newspaper, and I'm just so distressed. I mean, first they're talking about all this police brutality.
Yeah.
So what do you think about that?
Well, you know, about policemen. Well, I had a friend the other day. She got stopped by the policeman. And, you know, he pulled her over. The officer came to the door, license and registration. So she said, well, I'm so sorry I was speeding, officer, but I was on my way to the annual policeman's ball. And he said, well, lady, policemen don't have balls. She said, well, you don't.
I'm sure that he really got a kick out of that one. And you know, another thing I've been reading about is Hillary Clinton is running for president. What do you think about a woman as a president?
Well, I think it's wonderful to have a woman in office as a president, but if you're going to be a woman, you know, don't you think you should put on just a little bit of more makeup?
I'm telling you, darling, I think they all need to put on a lot more makeup. So then we can tell who are the women, okay? I mean, I'd be so distressed when I see these women. I'm like, are they really women? Anyway, darling. Noxzema, you got to tell us, how did you get started in show business?
Well, I started dancing with Anne Marie Garvin, and we were doing this show called Dance Between the Lines in San Francisco.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, I did that, and then I started touring. I went to Mexico and then started on tour and ended up somewhere in Vienna.
Wow.
And I decided to take a vacation to Berlin. So I go to Berlin and I meet my friend Martin, and we go down to the Kudamstrasse, which means the Kudam Street, where, oh, there were so many restaurants and peoples and show and people walking back and forth. And I said, I want to take a dance class, Martin. So I go into this building with all these people, and they ask me to stay and find out that it's not a dance class, that it is a real audition. Yeah, for Porgy and Bess. And
wow.
Guess what? I made it. And that night I met my agent, and the rest is history.
Wow, that is great. And I've heard that you're doing this new movie.
Yeah.
And it's going to be coming out soon. What's
yes.
the name of this movie?
The name of the movie is Drag Hill Zombies Meat Lovers. And it's about drag queens that are performing in the club, and one gets bit by a zombie and he affects the whole club, and they are all zombies.
Well, it just so happened that we have a short clip of that movie.
Ooh.
So let's take a look, can we?
Oh, yeah.
If the living dead war heals.
Before that gets back over here.
And I'm going out with Rita at the show.
They must be zombies in drag.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome here to the fabulous Drag Lagoon Club.
Sorry, bud. The kid doesn't have anything for you tonight.
Girl, you should stop taking all that that Rico gives you.
I mean, that you can do this, baby. Put on your big girl panties.
Drag Hell Pictures. In association with Vagabundo Films and Epical Productions present.
Going on, can you hear me knocking?
Drag Hell Zombies Meet Lovers.
What the fuck? Oh my god!
That was absolutely wonderful. I can't wait. So when is this movie coming out?
Okay, it's coming out this year. Drag Hill Zombies Meat Lovers this year to international, nationally, DVDs is coming out all over.
Okay, this is going to be great fun. So everybody, please look out for
Drag Hill Zombies Meat Lovers.
Okay, thank you, darling.
Mwah,
mwah. And we'll be right back with more of Susie Butler, Round Midnight.
Mm-hmm.
Did you have a nice drive?
What are you talking about?
Well, it's been so long since you've been out of the house, I just thought perhaps you went for a drive or something. You know, it's been so long since we had a talk, you know, about the future and everything. And I don't want you to worry about the house. And even if I have to sell it, we'll still be together.
Blanjika, you ain't selling this house. Daddy bought this house, and he bought it for me. You don't think I remember anything, do you?
You're wrong, Jane Keisha. You've just forgotten. I bought this house for the two of us after I signed my first contract.
You don't think I remember anything, do you? You know who bought this house? Little Jane Keisha bought this house. That's who.
You don't know what you're saying.
Blanjika, you're not selling this house and you ain't leaving it either. Oh.
Well, do you remember when I first came home after the accident?
You said you were never gonna mention that again.
I know, I did, but I'm still in this bulldog wheelchair. After all these years, I'm still in this chair. Now, doesn't that give you some kind of responsibility, Jane Keisha? You know, you wouldn't be able to do all these awful things to me if I wasn't in this bulldog wheelchair.
But you are, Blanjika. You're still in that chair. And what are all these awful things I was supposed to do to you? If you hadn't have gone down to the Occupy Oakland protest and the policeman's pet bulldog didn't bite you, you wouldn't be in that chair.
Well, I meant that you wouldn't have to work so hard. And I was thinking that Nene could come in more often and maybe she could even live with us.
We don't need no Nene.
Well, you always get so tired and there's so much to do and you're not well.
Maybe I do need a checkup or something.
Oh, that would be so wonderful. Maybe we can find a real Dr. Feelgood.
Dr. Feelgood. Yeah. Now, what is his number again? Oh, yeah. Under no circumstances, let my sister see this letter. It's not me that need a Dr. Blanjika.
Oh!
It's you!
Blanjika!
Can you tell?
Can you tell?
Does it look like I'm fighting a disease?
Fighting. Fighting for my life.
Like my life expectancy is shorter than yours?
There's no outward sign.
But we're battling every day.
Every day.
Every day.
Worrying. Testing.
Treating.
Fighting. Diabetes.
Diabetes has been called a silent epidemic. It's time to call it out for what it is. Help us raise awareness, hope, and vital funding. Help us stop diabetes.
Welcome back to Round Midnight. Our next guest is Turbo Ted. So, Ted, what have you been up to?
Been playing a lot of music.
Oh, really? Where?
All around Oakland, mostly. Mostly been recording. Been in recording studios.
Oh, that's good. So you're doing a new CD or?
I have a new solo album out.
Okay.
It's called Turbo Ted Is Still Dead. And since that's been released, I've already been recording a next set of material with our band Chief Enablers.
Oh, wow. That's great. Hey, you know, I was with you that night when we were recording, you guys were recording, and the police showed up. Can you tell me about that?
I'm never going to live this down, okay? We're there in the studio. It's a beautiful studio. There's a grand piano and professional drummer and all the studio and just 32-channel board. You know, it's our big, big moment, you know, and we're there. And one of the neighbors is this young guy. He called the cops on us, you know.
Really? Oh, and, yes, I remember that. In fact, I think we have a clip of that.
No.
Okay, because I was outside listening to it, and it is at the music or the drums is at an audible level where we could actually.
But if you could,
I don't need to come in there. I'm just like.
I just want to show you that there's an ISO booth. It isn't like we're just haphazardly doing.
Okay, but the thing is, it's loud, and I can hear it in the hallway, and I can go in there.
Okay. Sorry.
I can go in there and listen to it and hear it.
Okay.
And the actual.
I'm sorry. Can you either go over here or move back up there?
Thank you. The actual walls are
think they'll dispense of no insemination.
So what is possibly going to occur is this is the third time that a report has been on file, basically for the same complaint. So basically, they can go down to the courthouse and have a restraining order against you for the audible music.
That was one crazy night, huh?
You'd think as a middle-aged man, you wouldn't have the problems with the cops, you know. No one was arrested. It was okay. We're all right.
Uh-huh. Well, that's good. But anyway, the song that you did that night was called...
King-Sized Bed Without a Queen.
That is a great song. I love those licks and everything. How did you come up with that?
You're asking me to kiss and tell, Susie Bubba. I'll tell you, at least I wrote the lyrics laying on my back in a king-sized bed on my iPhone. I couldn't sleep, and the queen wasn't there. So.
Oh.
That's all I'll say.
Okay. Okay, Ted, this is the part of our show where it's called Susie Butler Call Cards. So you need to pick a card, and whatever on that card, you need to answer it truthfully. So pick a card and tell us.
This isn't going to hurt, is it?
It may.
I'll go with this one. Can you describe your worst one-night stand? You serious? My worst one-night stand. I've had a one-night stand before. Usually good. What would be a bad one? I learned when I was younger to like never bring them to your own house. You know, so that saves a lot of drama.
Number one rule.
The worst ones would be where the person didn't smell good. I'm a smell person. It has to smell nice.
Okay.
But I haven't had that many horror stories. And again, the key is don't bring him to your own house.
Exactly. That makes sense. Now, Ted, I really love this song, and I'm really looking forward to you performing it for us here today. Are you ready?
I'm ready. So this is a king-sized bed without a queen, and I'm performing with our group Chief Enablers.
Okay. Thank you.
One. Two, one, two, three, four.
Complexity.
King-sized bed without a queen. Toss and turn and I can't sleep. Distance drawn, time and space. Hold your horses, you must wait. Chessboard is out of peace. Prisoner of his own belief. Castle tower standing tall. Never fall. King size bed without a queen. King size bed without a queen. It's connected, it's all right. Lightning strikes us in the night. Open eyes, I count to see. Someone's fast asleep. Tree branch falls to the ground. Shook my leg, it makes no sound.
bed without a queen. King size bed without a queen. Size bed without a queen.
Hello? Hello? Yes? Who is this Tom Brady? You with your flat balls. Don't call me again.
Susan,
I've got... Hello? Hello? Oh, Derek Jeter, the cheater. Once a cheater, it's always a cheater.
Concert tickets, but don't see the show.
Hello? Okay. Hello? Bill, as in Clinton? Darling, your wife is running for the highest office in the land. Why are you calling me?
We can go see Millie, but not...
I'm known around town, darling, as a playgirl. Maitre d's call me by name. The men all agree that I'm grand company. Darling, my good nights are always the same. Call me again, darling, when you're in town. Oh, if nothing more, we'll just chat a while. Not this time, but maybe next year when you're here, darling, call me. Be sure to call me again, honey, when you're in town. Hello? Yes? This is she. Who did you say this was? A friend of Bill's? Darling, how is he? He's married now. Doing well. Father of darling twin girls. Oh, do tell. My. You give that boy my love the next time you see him. You hear? What did you say? Oh, yes. Isn't it a wonderful night? Well, I don't know. Well, perhaps for a friend of Bill's, I might. Meet you at the Fairmont Bar around 7:45. Oh, I'm sorry, darling, but I have another date. But you call me again, darling, when you're in town. Bye-bye.
Two free tickets for Drew Hill.
Hello? Hello, and welcome back to Susie Butler Round Midnight. We have another fabulous guest tonight, Maya Sungbird. Let's hear it for Maya. So, Maya, how did you get started in music?
Well, I've been singing my whole life. And up until 2009, I had kind of just been, you know, living the life of trying to fit in and go to work, but deeply inside, this is what I always wanted to do. And after losing my third job in 3 years, literally it was 3 years and three jobs, and I said, okay, I'm not supposed to be doing this with my life. And I just said, forget it all, start it from scratch, okay. And started this journey in music.
Oh, that's good. That's good. So, yeah, you just said, wait a minute, this isn't working. So, obviously, I'm supposed to be doing something else,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, how many songs have you written? Albums?
Lots. Let's see. I started out with a Lust single EP, and that was the first song that put me on the map. I've been writing since 12, but putting out music-wise, I've written about 4 albums and various miscellaneous other things that I've written that just haven't made it out. But
it's still there.
You
still have them. Okay, Maya. This part of the show is called Susie Butler's Code Card. So you need to pick a card. And whatever's written on that card, you need to answer it truthfully. So, pick a card, Maya.
Hmm. We picked a pretty card. What is the most scandalous thing that's happened to you in your music career? I'm going to spill the beans.
Yes.
Okay. Alrighty, well, starting out, pretty much, I met someone who, you know, did the whole charade of supporting me. And, you know, you're young in the industry and you're all happy and stuff because it seems like everything's going your way and you got the luck is in your favor. And he had this crazy idea of me. I was like, I want to put out an album called Castro Kid, because you know I'm from the Castro, and I was a Castro kid as a teenager. To make a long story short, we go ahead and raise money on Kickstarter, and we get the producer, and we're recording, we finish the project. At the end of the project, I get slammed with the most ugliest contract. Like, it was unbelievable. I said, oh my God. Oh my God, like I cried. It felt like Satan delivered it to me.
It was like a pebble sort of.
It was very much. It was like, now all you have to do is sign this contract.
Oh my God.
You know? And I was just like, what do I do? Everybody was like, get away, go away from that. My lawyer was like, don't you sign that contract, girl. You know what I mean? And it was kind of like this person was like, oh, I'm your friend also. Uh-huh. And it was kind of a lot of pressure on me. If you don't sign that contract, I'm going to take you to court and sue you for $10,000.
You know, this industry is pretty dirty.
Yeah, it got real ugly. It was something that definitely changed me and woke me up at the same time. And it taught me my power. It let me know that I don't have to do what somebody wants
exactly.
me to do. I do what I want to do,
yes.
You know? But that was intense for me. And at the end of the day, like, you know, it took me a long time to finally get a little bit of courage to come back to that project.
Okay.
And I'm happy to say that I recently put out a single from the project.
Oh, great!
So
what's the name of the single?
Don't Be Afraid of the Rapture.
Oh, okay.
It's all about facing your fears, which for me, so that you know what's real and what's an illusion.
Okay, yeah. There's a lot of illusions out
yeah.
there.
Yeah, and I was afraid of this person for so many years, you know, because they made all these threats to me about this project and not signing this contract, and I felt like I had no power, you know, but it definitely let me know that I have the power. I'm the one that's in control of the career.
So, Maya, before you perform for us today, how can people reach you?
Well, you can find me online at www.mayasongbird.com. That's M-A-Y-A Songbird, or type in on Google or any search engine, Maya Songbird, and I pop up and you'll find me.
Okay, we'll be right back with Maya singing Disco Bill.
Hey Disco Bill, you said you'd meet me at the top of the moon. This isn't fair, you had me hanging around till noon. I said I'd leave, but my heart said I should stay, I should stay, I should stay, I should stay. Thinking that you'd come for me anyway. I think I heard you're looking for love like me and all the love possibilities. I wanna know if you wanna stay a while. Hey Disco Bill, you should've told me this love's not real. Hey Disco Bill, you should've told me just how you feel. Thought Disco Bill was the ultra prince charming. Got dancing feet with a sweet old smile to melt every girl that meets him and drive her wild. Got wet panties on the dance floor. Oh, Disco Billy, tell me why you had to do it to me. Oh, Disco Billy, tell me why you had to do this to me.
Tell me why you had to do this to me.
Bye bye, Disco Bill, the love you felt isn't real. When we made love on the dance floor. No, 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 you don't love me. Never, never thinking of me. I can't stand to think you're not thinking of me. Disco Billy. I can't stand to think you're not thinking of me. Disco Billy. How you want something so bad? You know you just can't have it. You're not thinking of me. Bye bye, Disco Billy.
Bye
bye, Disco Billy.
Bye
bye, Disco Billy. Love you felt, it just wasn't real. When we made love on the dance floor, we made love on
got a spot in town, you can't go wrong. Welcome to Eclectic to You Showroom and Salon. Welcome to Eclectic to You Showroom and Salon.
Eclectic to You is not just another salon, but a lifestyle gallery offering hairstyling, a boutique, massage therapy, an array of social entertainment, including local bands, Chicago Steppin', and gospel karaoke. Located in Jack London Square at 100 Broadway, Oakland, California.
Love is like a never-ending melody. Poets have compared it to a symphony. Out of tune. Why show?